Okay, so far we have made some code which will take a booking for our cinema just here and save it to a CSV file. We've made a menu system which, if you choose number one, it will open up the booking system up here. And we're going to have a look at the second thing we can do, which is create a search. So in this case, it will search for a particular film name. Okay, so I'll just run this so you can see how it works before we explain the code. So we'll just save it, and this time I'm going to do search for by film name. So if I press 2, what I've done is I've just printed out all of the people in the database first. For the final program, we wouldn't have to do this. So if I type in a film name, it should return all of the people who are seeing that particular film. Okay, there we go. So these three people, so James Bob, Dave Strickland, and Bob Jones. And if we compare that with our database, we can see it's extracted the three people who are going to see the film Aliens. So how does this all work? Okay, so we've got some code here, which I've created it as a function, and I call it search booking ref, and I put the function in down here for choice 2. So it will call search booking ref when we press 2. And this is the code. Okay, so the first thing I've done in this bit of code is I've created a new list called data. And it's an empty list because we can see there's nothing inside the square brackets. And we've got a bit of code here. And what this does, this opens up our cinema CSV file, which is over here. And it copies all of the contents into the 2D array data. Okay, you can see here it says data append row. So it's going to get all the rows in the CSV file and copy them into the list, the 2D array called data. Okay, we need to do this because we need the data inside the Python program so we can search for it. So next step here, we've then got a input statement. Okay, and I've called it lookup. Now you can call it anything you like, that's just a variable name. And this is the bit where the user enters the name of the film. Okay, so this loop here is assigned the variable name col4, okay, which stands for column 4. All right. So what it will do is it will search through the fourth column in our 2D array, okay, which is called data. And if we have a look at the fourth column, now we've put 3 here because if you remember, it always starts at column 0. Okay, so 0 is this column, which is the booking reference. 1 is the surname, 2 is the first name, 3 is the film name. So we're searching what is column 3, but to us it's column 4, for the name of the film. Okay. Now the search is called column 4, okay, and that will just look in this column here. Okay, all right. And I've just put a print statement in, and this is literally just a test, okay, to see if it prints out all of the stuff in column 4. Okay, and we can just see this running. So if I run the program again and select option 2, you can see here, okay, it's just printed out the stuff in column 4. Okay, oh no, sorry, I haven't done that yet because we haven't searched for a film. Let's just search for one. And there we go. So there we go. That's that print statement there. It's just printed out all of the films. Okay. You'll see it says no film with that name because I haven't put the S on the end. So that is that print statement there. So next part of the program, we're saying if lookup is in column 4. Okay. So if whatever we've typed in as the film name is inside column 4, we need to do this loop here. Okay. So if we kind of go through column 4, which is here, and it's searching through, and it's if whatever we've typed in here, so aliens, if that's in this column, it will then do this loop. Okay, if it's not in this column, it will say no film with that name. Okay, so again, just to demonstrate, if we load up the program, and if I type in something completely different that's definitely not in there, it will say no film with that name because that's not in column 4. Okay, so if the film is in column 4, it will then move on and do this loop. Okay, and I'll just kind of demonstrate how this loop works, because loops can sometimes be a bit tricky. So I've just popped the code and the CSV file just here, okay, and I've just removed all of the different comments that we've got here, just to explain how this works. So we've got here 4K in range, okay, so that set up a loop from 0, which is the very first entry in column 4, to length column 4, and that is the end of column 4. Okay, in this case it's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so if we could see this in numbers, it would be 0 to 5. Okay, and we're saying down here, if column 4k is equal to lookup. Okay, now the first iteration of the loop is 0. Okay, so I'm just going to write a little 0 here. So, oops, 0. Okay, so if the first entry in that column is equal to lookup, then print it out. Okay, so let's have a look. So we'll go up here. Is the first entry, so 0, is that equal to, let's say we search for aliens. Let's type that up here. Aliens. Okay, let's say we search for that. Is that equal to whatever's in 0 in this column? Okay, no. All right, so because that says 24. So in other words, it won't print the information. Okay, but what it will do now is it will loop back around. Okay, so instead of, let's go to our pen again, instead of it being 0 now, it will now be 1, okay, because that's the second iteration of the loop. So again, it compares and it goes back up to the CSV and it looks in the first position of column 4, okay? Aliens, so is that equal to aliens? All right, yes it is. So in other words, it will print all of the data in that row, okay? And all of the data in that row is 80 Bob James Aliens Monday. Okay, so it will print everything in row 1 because that is equal to that. Okay, so it's printed that and it will now go around to the second iteration of the loop. And this time, the next iteration is 2. Okay, so it will then do the same thing. It will go back to the CSV. Is the second index of this column the same as lookup? So remember 0, 1, 2. Okay, aliens, yes, it is the same. So again, that will print out everything on row 2. All right, so this entry here. Then the loop goes again. Okay, and it goes around this time to number 3. Okay, that's getting a bit squished up there. And it will do the same thing. It will go back to the CSV and compare the third entry. So 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, now is aliens equal to Wolverine? Okay, no, it's not. So it won't print that data. Okay, it won't print whatever's in row 3. So you get the idea. The next iteration is number 4. Okay, so we would just have a number 4 here. So it's getting a bit squished up now. And again, it would do the same thing, and it would go all the way to number 5, okay, which is the last iteration. There we go, number 5, which does match. Okay, so it would print out. So in other words, it would print this line, and this line. Okay, but it wouldn't print those. And it's doing this because it's going round and round in a loop. Okay, and the loop only ends when it gets to the last point in the column. Okay, which is, in this case, the fifth entry. Okay, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that is essentially how this particular loop and how this search works. Okay, it will only print out what we search for. So just to see that all in action for real, I run the code again, and again just select the search option and let's search for 24. Okay. And there we go. So we've got two people, Jack Bauer and Nina Myers, who are going to watch 24. So it's looped around our CSV, worked out what indexes are listing 24, and printed them out. So slightly complicated, but that's essentially how it all works.